Dolls are often made to resemble real people to the point where they almost seem lifelike. Could a soul mistakenly possess the body of a doll, thinking it's a human? From the looks of it, there are some pretty spooky encounters to the point where you have to wonder if they're all just urban legends. From Elmo dolls that might make threats, to dolls owners claim to be haunted, here are the creepiest dolls you don't want to play with.
Hey guys, this is American Eye, bringing you another great video.
Number 17, Peggy. Everyone knows dolls can be extremely creepy, and this footage is proof, whether it's a hoax or not. Video footage of this haunted doll has scared, but also intrigued many paranormal investigators. Many have believed that this doll named Peggy was possessed by an evil spirit. A few people reported feeling nauseous and anxious when coming around the doll. One woman in the UK even claims it caused her to have a heart attack. The previous owner suffered from intense nightmares as well. Number 16, Possessed Doll. This cringe-worthy paranormal doll was found in Singapore next to a tree with a blindfold. Many passers-by were disturbed by the image, and they notified authorities of its presence. Written in Arabic, it said, "All in the name of God," across a blindfold. The story goes that whoever unwrapped the cloth or blindfold was to have the curse passed down to them. It's one way of getting rid of a curse, and this one looks like it has a really bad curse going on. The former owner claims that the doll had the ability to move on its own and actually speak in a woman's voice. You might want to keep your distance. Some had posted different ways one should go about getting the evil spirit out of the doll and various ways of destroying it. That certainly seems like a risky job to do. If the spirit comes out of the doll, it has to go somewhere, right? I would just say nope and walk away. Number 15, Ventriloquist Vampire. So what's more creepy than making a doll talk when you don't move your lips? Just about nothing, but how about a ventriloquist from the Victorian age using a creepy, possibly a child, as a puppet? No one should stick their hand in that thing. We all know how dolls like to be haunted. It definitely looks like one of these are. Once again, something about dolls from the past are just extremely terrifying and you can tell is quite evil. Please people, just keep your cameras away from the dolls so we can get some sleep already. Number 14, Stretch Armstrong. Have you ever contemplated on giving your kid a stretchable bodybuilder to play with? It was basically like a doll of stretchable glue that could stretch about 4 times its actual size. Kids would pretty much punish this thing and took their aggression out on it until it eventually snapped. There really wasn't too much else you can do with it, but still kinda creepy. Number 13, Pregnant Barbie Doll. Turns out Barbie had a friend named Minge who might have been a bad influence on Barbie. Now you don't have to teach your kids where babies come from because this Barbie doll will do that for them. This doll here was actually controversial at the time because people believed that the doll looked too young and shouldn't be having a baby. No word on whether or not Ken decided to stay and help out. Number 12, Horrifying Reborn Dolls. Dolls are without a doubt creepy, and these ones are just about as creepy as it gets. These aren't your average dolls that you might get at a store for your kids. These are lifelike, computer-scanned, and 3D-printed dolls of babies. One site called Reborns.com offers these lifelike replicas for as much as $700. Some claim the reasons behind it are quite bone-chilling as well. Women who've had stillbirths in the past or are unable to have kids might buy these in an attempt to feel some attachment to the baby they were supposed to have. The dolls are so realistic that they've resulted in many 911 calls when people leave them in cars or if they alter the doll in some way. It can just be downright terrifying. So do yourself a favor and don't Google this. Some collectors who've lost their minds treat them as if they're really their kids. Number 11, Yume. Certainly not all dolls are happy. This one here is sold in Japan, and the ones who actually play with her can literally make her cry. But first, in order to do that, you have to inject her arm with a syringe. What kind of values are we teaching the kids? Something about this just seems a tad unsettling. Number 10, Shave the Baby Doll. Who would seriously buy this, and what if I don't want to shave the baby? Turns out this one isn't real in a sense that it was never exactly on shelves anywhere. This was actually a conceptual art design from a crazy Polish artist in 1995. Whatever the message he was trying to get across in this one, we're not sure of, and we'd like to hear what you guys think about it in the comment section. Number 9, Barbie Forever and Tanner. Some toy companies are really trying too hard to make their toys more realistic than they should be. We all imagine Barbie being a professional dog walker at some point, so it makes sense to have this type of doll, right? In 2005, the toy featured pretend poop that the dog would actually have to put in its mouth in order for it to come out the backside. She was then equipped with a magnetic scooper. The toy was later recalled due to choking hazards. Gross. Be sure to warn your kids that is not chocolate. Number 8. Life-size ET doll. The Coast Guard who came across this might have really thought she discovered the body of an extraterrestrial or maybe a turtle with no shell. It turns out it was a life-size doll of ET which had been stolen from this woman we see in the photo. She was quite happy when he got him back. When returned, ET was only missing a finger but is still in good shape. Number 7. Barbie Collection. How many dolls does it take for someone's personal collection to start becoming creepy? Trick question, they're all creepy. Jian Yang from Singapore poses in this photo with his collection at home. He seems to be immune to the creepiness and it doesn't affect him. Maybe his doll collection has gone a bit too far, but don't tell him that. He has a collection of more than 6,000 Barbie dolls. This man doesn't even really need wallpaper or anything like that because his walls are basically covered in Barbie dolls. Barbie dolls also range from some famous characters such as Elizabeth Taylor, Frank Sinatra, and Marilyn Monroe. If this place ever became abandoned, you can imagine that it would get really creepy. Number 6. Horrendous Pencil Sharpener. This is probably something you don't want to get your kid if you don't want to give them nightmares. Not all pencil sharpeners allow you to stick a sharp object through its eye. The one we see here is called Sadie Pencil Sharpener and was designed by Matthew James Taylor. It's complete with blood coming out of the eye and the shavings are ejected from the mouth. Unless you approve of your child becoming gothic, this isn't a pencil sharpener they should own. Number 5. Island of Dolls. Located near Mexico City, this is certainly a creepy, mysterious place that might run chills down your spine. The island is flooded with spooky dolls tied up and dangling from a tree. These would not make for good Christmas decorations. The history and tales told about this place make many wonder if it's truly haunted. Accounts of why the island was decorated this way seems to vary. Many claim to see the dolls moving around at night and can even hear them whispering to each other. Is this all their imagination? Number 4. Harold. Apparently, the first haunted doll to be sold on eBay, Harold has attracted much attention from paranormal investigators. Previous owners have said to be plagued with horrible diseases, sudden illnesses, and injury after seeing the doll actually make a smile at them. Something just really seems off about this one, and from this view, you can tell it's missing an eye as well. Number 3. Amelia. If your kid asks you to buy them this extremely haunted looking doll of Amelia, you have to wonder how your kids will turn out. This one was actually auctioned off on eBay, claiming that the toy was not for the weak of heart and not any little kid should ever have this in their bedroom. The previous owner claimed that her eyes were the source of her power and would change colors depending on her mood. Finally, they claimed that her eyes went from blue to being permanently green. No one would seriously make a doll with green eyes like that, would they? In any case, it's pretty creepy, and the owner also claimed to have seen it walk through the hallway giggling. Number 2. Elmo Knows Your Name. Don't tell this Elmo your name, or he may never forget who you are. It's almost as if the doll was just designed to be digitally possessed. A young kid named James was excited when his parents were able to find him one of the last Elmo Knows Your Name dolls off the shelves. That was at first. The doll was programmed to remember James' name and would recite personal phrases. After a while, it was clear that those phrases got extra personal to the point where it was actually threatening James. The parents thought it was some type of malfunction, but after a while, it was clear what the doll was saying.
Her audio was captured on tape, and you'll never believe what it said.
And number 1. Annabelle the Cursed Doll. Could anything possibly seem more horrifying? Annabelle the doll was found at an antique shop and dates back to the 1970s. As soon as a little girl named Donna brought it home, she began to notice things weren't quite right. The doll would unexpectedly move from different locations when Donna wasn't paying attention. She brushed it off as forgetfulness, but from then on, it only escalated. The doll would mysteriously have drops of blood on its skirt and seemingly walked around. After doing an investigation, they found out that the girl who had previously owned it unexpectedly lost her life. After taking it to a psychic investigator, they claimed that it was possessed by a demon that was after her soul. The doll now sits at a museum in a case that warns people, do not open.